Anti-government demonstrations still hounding Chile. Protesters returned to the streets Tuesday to denounce inequality, despite calls from lawmakers to pursue economic reforms. The latest round of demonstrations was the biggest so far, resulting in violent clashes between the police and activists. Protests began in early October, sparked by an increase in public transport fares. At least 15 people have already died since the unrest broke out. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department calling on Filipinos in Chile to take necessary precautions amid the ongoing unrest there. The agency advises them to stay indoors and avoid unnecessary travel to affected areas. So far, no Filipino has been affected from the ongoing protests in Santiago. Some 800 Filipinos are living in Chile, most of them residing in the capital. Now let's now get an update on the protests and violence in Chile. We're now joined on the line by Maita Antonio. She's a Filipino living in Los Andes, Chile. Maita, thanks for joining us.
Hi, good morning.
Hi, we understand it is 6 a.m. there. We appreciate that you're online with us. You're not in the city center, Santiago, but you're no less affected by the protests or the declaration of the state of emergency. Can you share with us your situation there and how you're protecting yourself?
The protests, although we are not close to the capital, for 70 kilometers away from it, our president declared a state of emergency, meaning we have curfew hours. We have to close our business early. There's no banks. There's no school for our kids. The supermarket, we have time for us to shop our foods, and we have limited movements around town. And some of our people, my workers, they can't work because of limited time of curfew hours. And it's so terrifying that there's worldwide, nationwide looting. And we fear that our business gets burned or get looted by these delinquent people.
Right. So what kind of protection have you been doing and how are you surviving with no banks and no supermarkets around? Is there support being, set by the government?
We have militaries in the streets. We have carabineros, our police, and also our PDI, Policía de Investigaciones. They are the people who, they are the government workers who secure the lives of civilian people. They help us get through our lives normally. But even in the morning, even they are announcing protests on our telephone, and before the protest starts, we have to secure our business. I have a helateria. It's a ice cream business here in Chile. I'm in the heart of the town of Los Andes, and I have to close early. I have to put steel metal security. So in case they throw Molotovs inside our business, it will not, it will prevent it from burning.
Since two days
now, it has been quiet protest. Instead of them, they are doing, they're banging pots and pans now. And they're trying to do the protest in the quiet way.
Right.
Last night, our president spoke already. Mm-hmm. The protesters want high increase of wage, minimum wage. Our president gave it already from 300 to 350,000 now. They want increase in pensions of our old elderly people, and our president gave 24% more. There are more demands, but basically our government are trying to meet them. As of now, we hope that this will end. The metro train fare increase was already suspended. So now they're opening more trains in the city for public people to be able to use.
Maita, how many years have you been in Chile, and is this the first time that you've ever been experiencing this kind of unrest? Are there fears that martial law might be imposed?
I've been living in Chile for 15 years. Yeah, this is the first time that this happened to us. I don't think so. Martial law will be. Our president already declared a state of emergency in different places of the country. The people, 1973, when martial law was declared here in Chile, our older people knows and feel how it was. And the main rioters, protesters are the college students. They are the jóvenes, they are the young people. They haven't experienced those, but I think and I believe that when our demands are met, the protesters are met, I think the Chilean people will come down and will follow what our president are trying to meet their demands.
Now, what about communications with our Philippine embassy? Are you in contact with the embassy as well as the rest of the Filipino community there? What are the communications that have been reaching you?
We have a Facebook page. When the riot started Friday, they sent a message through there stating that we have to follow the curfew hours. We have to abide by the law in order for us to be safe. And whatever happens to us, they give us a contact number, and that's it. Majority of the Filipinos living here in Chile are domestic helpers. They live with their bosses. And the only time that they got off from work is Friday, 5, and then Saturday and Sunday are the day off. Majority of them uses the bus, micros, as public transportation, and also metro trains. Since Friday, I will give you an example. My sister lives in Chile, also in Santiago. Normally, her commuting time is 30 minutes from her work to her home. It took her 6 hours. They have to walk. They have to take different types of. She has to hitchhike. She took different types of transportation just to get home. She was
just
bombed
to get around the protests.
Asthma. Yes. It was. And I asked her if I can go, and she told me, don't ever go here in Santiago. It's very dangerous.